إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. سبحانك لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك، أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر وأنت على كل شيء قدير. اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما، واجعل التفرق بعده تفرقا معصوما، ولا تدع فينا شقية ولا محرومة. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him, and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him, and he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I do bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. Jazakum Allah khayran for being with us. Barakallah feekum. Quick reminder that in case if you would like to know what we were saying the past weeks, in case you can go to Dar Foundation web, YouTube channel and Facebook channel, and as well Brother Naeem Jazakallah khair Abu Umar in .banat B-A-N-A-T. You can find, and my page as well, you can find the full series in case if you want to catch basically what we are saying. Okay, now today I will be tackling two main concepts, or from my point of view, to the best of my knowledge, I will be doing my best to fix two main misconceptions about hasad, envy, and talabbus al-jinn lil-ins, the demonic position when it is believe that the Satan or the Jinni that controls physically the full body by getting into it and controls in it. This is part of our talking about Sihr, Jinn, and the story of Sulaiman alayhi salam. Okay? Now, today we will be tackling these two concepts, inshallah, in as much as I can in an academic way to try to convey what I know to you in a way to give you this kind of satisfaction to understand your religion in a better way, inshallah. Now, let's just go back few steps to know the context. We are dealing with Surah Al-Baqarah. We came across قول الله تعالى وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينُ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانَ. In that verse, I think 100 or 102, we highlighted the concept of the accusation and the bigger context of that. We are in the context of listening to the examples that Allah is highlighting about a group of people preceded us. Some people call them our cousins, okay? Preceded us. They used to follow a messenger and a prophet that we respect highly. They used to be at a certain time believers, and they were called Muslims, okay? However, they were asked to follow the latest updated version of the same source who gave them their book. They refused. Okay? So many things happened. Now we believe as Muslims that we have what we call the last testament. We have Old Testament, New Testament. Ours is last testament. In the last testament, Allah is giving us lessons, part of them from the stories of those people who received something like us and how they reacted. In chapter Al-Baqarah, at least up to now, about more than 25 lessons from this group of people in specific, okay? Part of the lessons, their status, their standpoint against Sulaiman alayhi salam. That's just to put you in the context what we are doing, why we are highlighting this and that. We are in the context of what? فَنَبَذُوهُ وَرَاءَ ظُهُورِهِمْ كَأَنَّهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. So Allah revealed to them the latest updated version. نَبَذُوهُ, they throw it back. Instead they did what? They followed what Satan's used to recite and to spread in the time of Sulaiman. Just to put you in the context. They used to claim with this span of time, as I told you, Musa alayhi salam, more or less around historically. We don't have clear-cut evidence in the Quran or the Sunnah. Historically, it's claimed to be it's around 3,500 from now. So for us, about 2000 years between him and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sorry, Musa alayhi salam. So Sulaiman alayhi salam, at least more or less about 700 years before اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد 3000 في انه 1700 BC I forgot anyway long time between سليمان عليه السلام and محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم I missed the connection the point during these hundreds of years This great prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam was accused that he used to be very powerful in his time, controlling the jinn using the sihr. So Allah now in this ayah is purifying, cleansing this big accusation against Sulaiman alayhi salam. In this context, he mentioned to us, وَمَا كَفَرُوا سُلَيْمَا وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ السِّحْرَ We highlighted the concept of Harut, Marut, why, when, how, and we finished. Then we jumped to the idea. We highlighted the concept of jinn as according to the chapter of jinn. And we said, be careful, we are a people of the scripture. Alhamdulillah, we are the only group on earth now. We have an authentic, genuine connection of our scripture to its original source without any kind of corruption. And we have what we call in our terminology, tawatur. Tawatur means we are fully certain, 100% as if we are witnessing the thing as a tangible asset, okay? That it was revealed in this way. Unless Allah is telling us that such and such happened with Sulaiman alayhi salam, your mind cannot accept the whole idea of controlling the jinn يَعْمَلُونَ لَهُ مَا يَشَاءُ مِنْ مَحَارِمٍ we highlight all of this in that and we finished all of this alhamdulillah in case if you would like to know what we did the last I think at least four sessions just in these concepts the last four sessions today as subtitle of this we will deal with the concept of hasad and the concept of the demonic position when someone is possessed by the jinn as its claim because it's widely spread especially in the Arab world يقول لك لبسوا الجن you know which means that he was fully controlled physically the jinn or the shaitan came into his body and he's controlling his full movement and he's speaking with different tongues on his behalf and he can do nothing about that okay now we will tackle this point let's come first to the hasad طب why I'm highlighting the hasad For two reasons. Hasad means envy. Okay? Why? For two reasons. Because practically, from our experience, many people, they misunderstand the concept of hasad. Plus, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the hasad immediately after the witches in Surah Al-Falaq. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقْ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا I will explain the meaning now. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقْ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وقب من شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد so they belong to the very close area together Allah mentioned them in the order immediately after so some people they might mix some people they might think that something has to do with the other so need to highlight to have a clear vision about your aqidah okay now let's come to the practical widely spread notion among the people which is not true from practical experience many Muslims think that hasad envy is an amazing secret power when someone is doing the action of hasad against me he's an influencing me affecting me harming me hurting me some people they exaggerate with this understanding and then bring some myths and lies and something to a degree that they became you know have this kind of phobia against this person because he's hasid this hasid if he came to my house may Allah be with my soul he will destroy the planets he will bring things down lights will stop and something you know they will mix with some kind of magic things people they think he's because he's hasid First misconception. What is, do you remember at the very beginning, we said we have definitions. No definition, no prohibition. If you don't define what we are tackling, you are losing and wasting your time. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَسْدٍ إِذَا حَسَدْ. Hasad, envy is mentioned. But what is hasad? Here comes the true, let's say, challenge. Allah said, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقْ. Say, I seek refuge by the Lord of the Falaq. Falaq is the very early morning. Okay? مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقْ. Oh Allah, protect me. Oh the Lord of the morning, the Lord of the time. Protect me from the evil of everything you have created, regardless what it is, when, how, have no idea. Oh Allah, protect me. And وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبْ. The darkness, when darkness comes, it's called al-ghasiq. When it controls and widely spread, everything is completely dark. Oh Allah, protect me from anything happens at the time of the darkness, which, you know, crimes happens mostly, you know, at dark time. Thieves, they attack, they do their robberies and they attack our houses at mostly at night. Now they are very professional, they don't care because they are protected by law. Wallahi, some countries, wallahi, some countries, when you see the laws against thieves, you can't think but thieves are those who put the law. Because it's designed to protect the thief, not to protect you as a citizen. Are you with me? Anyway, for everything, most of these things happens at night. So therefore, Ya Allah, protect me from al-ghasiq idha waqab. Now let's come to our point. This is the context. وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ. النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ, they are the witches, sahirat. When they cast spells and they do, you know, they cast spells and they do this, tie the knots. Yeah, for example, part of very woolly tradition of magicians, they used to do something, we don't know why you do it. I told you, the reality of sihr, we don't know it, okay? Part of the phenomena that they used to do, you know, spreading scary against the people, they used to make some knots, you know? Tight it like this way and put sometimes some pins, some whatever. They do this kind of strange thing which contains sihr that we don't know how they do it, how they influence. And I gave you many examples how it could be by analogy. Do you remember? The Bluetooth, the IR, something. It's a knowledge, chemistry, something. It contains. They used to do it. Now, this harmful thing which is part of the magic, oh Allah, protect me from them. Now, وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَد. Look, the definition of hasad in language is تمني زوال النعمة أو محبة زوال النعمة عن الغير. Definition is when I wish that the blessings that has been sent down to you, I wish, I would love, I will be happy if it was taken out of you. For example, Allah blessed you with being the first in your class. Allah blessed you with the very powerful, for example, body, with muscles for the men, for example. Allah blessed her that she's very beautiful. Allah blessed her with a very nice family. They are what? Ni'am. Envy, it's the feeling, be careful. Tamanni is what? I'm wishing. Mahabbat is what? I love, I wish, I would like to. All of them, they are what, where? Feelings. So I have this kind of thinking and feeling, I would love, which means I will be happy. Allah blessed you with a new car. After working 2 years in your career, you managed to buy a nice car with a halal money. If I'm envying you, basically, what I would like now, I wish if you made a car accident now. If you did, oh, I will be released. This is hasad. Okay? So far, this is the definition of hasad. What does Allah say in the Quran? Look. وَمِنْ أَوْ Allah قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ وَمِنْ شَرِّ. Oh Allah, I seek refuge by you from what? From the hasad? قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن حاسد ومن شر حاسد من شر حاسد. Be careful. The حاسد, the envier, is the one who has the feeling that he's wishing if I lose my blessings. Okay? Feeling. Wishing. As long as it's inside him, he's doing the action of أمراض القلوب. It is a heart action, not a physical action. This is sin. He deserves a lot of what? Sins because of it. But no one knows about it. Allah just. Myself, himself, and Allah. This is a sin. It's haram. And Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in a hadith, which is has some kind of good authenticity, narrated by more than one of the narrators, like Ibn Hibban, Abu Dawood. It says, اللهم صل على سيدنا إياكم والحسد فإنه يأكل الحسنات كما تأكل النار الحطب. Be careful to envy anyone, because when you have, when you accept, okay, when you allow yourself to have this feeling without removing, without deleting, without changing, without doing istighfar, which means you accept being an envier against someone because Allah gave him a ni'mah, you are a hasid, la samahallah, this will be deleting, this will be removing the hasanat, the rewards from your record, from your account, like the fire when the fire burns and eats the wood. You know, you have a piece of wood, you know, very tough. The fire keeps eating metaphorically. This piece of wood, at the end, it will be ashes. Nothing. Ramad. This is like the image of what the hasad does with your hasanat. Okay? Allah is asking us to seek refuge by him from the sharr of the hasad, which means from the evil of the hasad. So we have now two, what? Things. We have al-hasid, that he is doing the action of hasad within his heart, plus the possible sharr, evil, which is an external thing now. The evil of the hasad. The fact that I'm a hasid in itself is a sin. I deserve to be punished unless if I repent. And already I'm losing my hasanat. No one knows except Allah. If my hasad reached to high level, I might decide to move from phase one to phase two. What is phase two? Huh? Yes, practical action. So I'm not satisfied just by al-hasad. So I decide to go and do something practical. For example, the fact that I wish that you lose your car is hasad. The crime is fulfilled. I'm a sinful person. And this is what the Quran is saying, and that's the hasad. That's it. But sometimes I might go and do something with the car at night. I bring a big, for example, nail with me and you know, I scratch the car, it causes him $3,000 or $10,000 just to repaint the car. This is sharr, evil action because of my hasad. So Allah is asking us to seek refuge from the hasad or from the sharr of the hasad. The sharr of the hasad, be careful. Which means there is nothing such as the fact that someone is hasid immediately I will be harmed because of secret power. This is a myth. Forget it. Got the point? Because by the way, maybe 10 hasad, maybe 1,000 person is having the heart action of hasad against you and you have no idea about it. And you will not know, but Allah knows. And you are not asked to do anything because you have no access to know them, aslan. So be careful. Don't accept the explanation, because some people, they start to develop some kind of phobia against anyone who might be thought that he is a hasid, okay? They will not allow the people to come to their houses. They will have suspicious, you know, attitudes towards everyone is looking at them in a suspicious way. No, please.
We know the hasad now. No one can know who is the hasid because it's a matter of heart. طيب, what does the Quran say? He's teaching us to seek refuge by him from the evil. The evil could be anything. Anything such as, imagine that you are the first in your class or the first in your college, in university. Everyone loves you. So there is a hasid for you or a hasida for you at your college, at the university. Is it possible, by the way? Yes. You are a smart person, nice, welcoming everyone, helps everyone, and you are the first, you know, straight A's, all of your grades, mashallah. And this could apply to anyone of the sisters or the brothers. Someone is hasid for you. You don't know about him. Practically, if he decided to move to phase two, what are the possible things that he or she can do? Many things. Many things. He can just create a fake account on the Facebook claiming that you buy marks, you know, buy money, and you have invited two of your professors into the farm of your father, and you give them a bribe. Just a lie, fake. And anyone has some kind of slight hate for you will welcome this rumor. Maybe in 2-3 months, at least few hundreds, easily they believed it. They started re-questioning your marks. They started having suspicious attitude towards you. They. Can he harm you? Yes, طبعا. Yes. It could happen. طيب, she is the best in the class. Very well, mashallah. High manners and akhlaq. She has someone that she has an amazing envy against her. The easiest. In the Arabic style. Do you know what is the easiest? بحطش بزمتي كيف بتجيب العلامة. Do you know what does it mean? Do you know the Arabic style? What does this mean? She's indirectly indicating that she's using her femininity to go to the offices of the doctors to gain marks by doing some kind of bad things. Wallahi, this happens. This happens. Many people, they suffer from that. What is this? This is because of what? Hasad. This is the practical evil action that could happen at any moment. طيب, pause now. The Quran is teaching us the following message. I was just explaining to you what could happen practically behind the scene. This is the hasad and this is the evil, okay? Possible evil. طب, can we as a human beings have any way to access all possibilities and control them and prevent them? It's what? Impossible. I repeat, impossible. Therefore, as if, I will do it in my simple way, simple words, as if Allah is telling us, oh my servants, if you want a divine insurance, full protection, 24/7, depend on me. If you don't want, face the consequences. If you can't protect yourself, go and do it. Good the point? Good the point? That's why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used not to go to sleep without reading al-mu'awwadhat, for example. And ayat al-kursi, and you know, many things. Hadith al-sahih, I told you many times. من قرأ ayat al-kursi قبل أن ينام لا يزال عليه ملك يحرسه من الشيطان حتى يصبح. Your mind, just this kind of whispering, this kind of filthy, dirty ideas and dreams that could come to your mind while you are sleeping just to take rest and tranquility, you will be protected. Oh, Sheikh, but you know, no. Do you believe or not? Prophet told you about this. This is part of the unseen. ذال ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب. It's part of the غيب. We believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We believe in the existence of Allah. We believe that the Quran is the book of Allah. Allah is telling us either directly through the Quran or through Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Either you know, in the area of faith, either you take it or leave it. We don't have what? Pick and choose. Should pick and choose? Garmezunagi. You remember Garmezunagi? Do you remember it? You have to memorize it. This is a pure Jordanian one. Garmezunagi. Okay? We don't have Garmezunagi, especially in the area of faith. The whole idea of Islam we don't have the concept of pick and choose, which means, okay, I like this from Islam, I will take it. No, this does not go with my style of life, you know? We don't accept it. But this is in hadith sahih, you know. Some ulama said this could not be hadith aslan, and they decided to reject the whole sunnah. so it is a disaster. Anyway, so by understanding قَالْ وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدٍ. So the whole idea, when you understand, you will not be submitting yourself just to fake myths, خرافات كل شوي, okay? All the time. No. The idea is clear. Do we have حاسدين? Yes. Could it be half of the people around us? Yes. Can I know them? No. Is it possible to know some of them coincidentally by the will of Allah? Yes. Can I control their hearts? No. Can I know what they are planning practically as phase two after being hussad? No. Can I No. The full protection is depend on Allah. That's why I call a'udhu rabb al-falaq. Close the file. That's it. This is the whole idea of hasad. So please don't mix things that they don't relate. Why I'm telling you? You know, I am in this field more than 30 years. I receive hundreds of cases. They come. حاسدني وحسديتني وحسديتني وحسدتني دخلت على بيتي وطلعت على كذا ووقعتها دخلت على كذا طلعت علي حسدتني ووجهت لي وشعاع ليزر وطقتني من تحت وكذا. It's craziness. A lot of misconceptions. They are spread. They became as if they are part of the aqidah, which is not. Simply, your pure aqidah, this is part of... Clear. Clear so far. This is what? Hasad. شر الحاسد, how to be protected. The idea, the most important idea of this, before I finish this, to go to the idea of تلبس الجن. The position of the jinn. The whole idea, if you want the protection of Allah, be close from Allah. If you want the protection from everything that you know or you might not know, which is the case, you don't know. Because it's impossible to control what the people might be thinking about you. Millions of people, thousands of people. You don't know. By the way, maybe if I said this 20 or 30 years ago, many people, they say, the people who know me, they are hardly 10 or 15. Now, because of this social media... Sorry. Okay. I forget what I was saying. Okay. 20 years ago, before the social media, Most of us, we know very limited numbers, and very limited numbers know us. Now, the one who knows no one knows 500. The one who has nothing to do with any kind of fame or celebrity, he knows 500 and 1,000 knows him. Are you with me? Because of the social media. So, the possibility of someone to envy you is much more higher. The divine prescription, I seek refuge. By who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Period. طيب, your question. Huh? Al-Ayn is completely something else. I will mention it in another time, not today. يعني, in purpose, I don't want to mention it now because it has a different angle. Okay, I'm talking just about hasad now, just the hasad, which is clearly mentioned, okay? Because Ayn has a lot of dispute in understanding it. Now the hasad is clearly in the Quran, it's clearly mentioned and very easy to explain to this group of people. That's why I postponed that one, okay? Jazakum Allah khair. Yes. Yes, definitely. This is what the ayah is telling. This is what I want to tell you. It definitely, Jazakallah khair, the whole lesson, if he did hasad, he can't harm you. She can't harm you. And actually, you don't know aslan that she is hasida. Aslan, you don't know. You have no idea. Unless if she decided to. Yet, still, maybe you don't know. So, we don't know this and we don't know that. We might be aware of second phase because now it's an action. And might discover the action after everything has been done. Okay? Okay, the protection. قل أعوذ برب. رب الفلق. يا الله. And by the way, this is not just for the hasad, for everything in our life. Completely, you don't know. That is the part of the meaning. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who said that? Ibrahim عليه السلام. Which means everything in my life is for Allah, because of Allah, for the sake of Allah. And قال وإذا مرضت فهو يشفين والذي هو يطعمني. He is the one who feeds me and who gives me the drink and who gives everything. So this is basically the full idea of the true believer and the true Muslim. Full submission depending on this faith. By this, you will not be harmful. Whether now we have the two concepts now, the jinn and the hasad, the human beings. Now, okay, let's go to the other part, which is the position of, or the demonic position, that we call it in Arabic, talabbus. Now, go back to what I highlighted in the last three sessions, when I gathered to you all of the expressions in where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the relation between shaitan and the human beings. Do you remember? We highlighted them many times. I repeated them because I want to fix them in your mind. One of them is waswas. One of them, yanzagh, spoil, to corrupt, spread corruption. ينزغ بينهم. One of them is what? يخوف أولياء. Okay? Spread fear. One of them is? What else? Do you remember?
Forgetting.
Huh?
Forgetting.
Makes you forget. فأنساهم ذكر الله. He made them to forget. None of them by any way has anything to do with the direct physical control. None of them. Tens of places in the Quran. Are you with me? طيب. Where did the idea come from? To the two most important basic possible misunderstanding came from hadith sahih narrated in Bukhari and Muslim and from a Quranic verse. To a certain extent, it was misunderstood. What is the Quranic verse? Who knows what is the Quranic verse? That because of it, this kind of possible misunderstanding has been spread, you know, for ages between Muslims. But who knows the Quranic verse? Misunderstanding that the shaitan could have the ability to control us physically by position controlling inside our bodies and our tongues and speaking our languages and. طب انت بنتي ما انت بتعرفي يعني تحكيش. سمعتي 50 مرة أنا بحكيها. No.
وش سورة شيخ؟
No. I'm asking you if you know what's the verse.
وش سورة؟
والله I don't know the سورة. I know the verse. طيب. إن الذين يأكلون الربا لا يقومون إلا كما يقوم الذي يتخبطه الشيطان من المس. Do you know this ayah? All of you know it. And by the way, this ayah is number one of adillah that is used to prove the other way of understanding, which is now إن الذين يأكلون الربا لا يقوم. ما شاء الله جزاكم الله خير فبارك الله فيكم. شكرا يا أبو عمر. الله يجزيك الخير. أقبال يا رب ما نصب لك القهوة في الجنة إن شاء الله. إن شاء الله. بعد عمر طويل طبعا. إن شاء الله. إن شاء الله. Now I will read the ayah in Arabic and English. الذين أعوذ بالله السميع العليم الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الذين يأكلون الربا لا يقومون إلا كما يقوم الذي يتخبطه الشيطان من المس. ذلك بأنهم قالوا إنما البيع مثل الربا وحل الله البيع وحرم الربا. Those who consume interest or usury, ربا, will stand on judgment day like those driven to madness by Satan's touch. That is because they say trade is no different than interests or usury. But Allah
has permitted trading and forbidden interest. Okay? Allah. Now this ayah is talking about what? What is the main theme of this ayah?
Riba.
Allah is describing those who accept to deal with riba. So the idea, sorry, the main theme, the focal point of the ayah is not jinn and position and something. This is an example that was used in the context. So the core theme is what?
Riba
and those who deal with riba. So Allah is describing the status of those people who deals with riba when they are resurrected on the day of judgment from their graves. They will be like the one who تخبطه الشيطان من المس. Here comes the misunderstanding. يتخبطه الشيطان من المس. Now the word mas is translated, most of the ulama, is junoon. Madness. Craziness. Now the misunderstanding came from the word يتخبطه. I'm not generalizing. Especially, I'm talking now not about the ulama, I'm talking about the lay people. For example, in Bilad al-Sham, in Syria, Lebanon, Palestine, and Jordan, to the best of my knowledge, the word khabata, yakhbutu, khabtan means to hit. بقول لك خبطوا في الأرض, which means what? He was, you know, he hit him with the ground. Now, the definition of التخبط in Arabic. By the way, when you study Arabic very well, you will discover that most of us, we don't know Arabic. Wallahi. Wallahi. Now, تخبط in Arabic قال سارة على غير هدى. المتخب in Arabic, what's the definition? يسير على غير هدى. The one who does not know where he is going. He's just lost here and there and here and there. He's called متخبط in Arabic language. He's not the one who was hit like this. This is a slang language, street language. The Arabic language is what? The one who, oh my God, Bassam. انت جيت الحمد لله على السلامه حبيبي كيف حالك يا حبيبي ما شاء الله عليك والله انا لازم اقطع الدرس كيف حالك تعال اسلم عليك السلام عليكم ما شاء الله عليك كيف حالك
الحمد لله
احلى قصه شعر هاي ما شاء الله هذا بسام البطل ادب طفل شفته يمكن بكندا كلها بالامانه والله والله بدون مبالغه the most polite kid I have seen in Canada والله without exaggerating ما شاء الله هذا بسام حبيبي حبيبي ان شاء الله عشان هيك ما بقدرش ما اقطع اسلم عليك كان مسافر طبعا الله يخلي لك يا اخي يا ما شاء الله هو السؤال القوي طب وين ماسع عنك ها بس قصت شعرك من الاخر حبيبي انا ما شاء الله اوكي وات اي واز سينج اوكي يتخبطوا اوكي Now, التخبط السير على غير هدى. When you are walking, knowing nowhere, you know, going to nowhere, you don't know where you are going. You have no, no destination. You don't realize. Just, you know, walking. Okay, where are you going? I don't know. Like the drunk. You know, if someone is completely drunk and he's walking, if you ask him, where are you going? Is there an answer? This is متخبط. Now, this is used as a metaphor. When someone in his life has no clear vision where he's going, he's called what? متخبط. Now, in Arabic, we call this is استعارة. It's part of the, you know, rhetorical language. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing the status of those people who deal with the riba in the day of judgment. Like those who were touched by the Satan and they were doing takhabbut because they were mad. They are now crazy people. They have no clear vision where to go in the life. Just, you know, here and there and here and there. A crazy person who has no clear vision or destination. Okay? It has nothing to do with any indication of explanation that the body of the Satan has getting into it and controlling the muscles and speaking on his behalf and come saying, you know, this is this ayah, this is the meaning of the ayah. And by the way, I know some scholars, they have another explanation. But after spending years and years and trying to understand the problems, I mean, I will be very happy if you took this explanation as the understanding which is more closer to the spirit of Islam. If you want to go to delve into other things, you need a lot of knowledge to understand the details, okay? But I'm giving you just in a simple way. So what is the other evidence that has been misunderstood somehow? It's a hadith sahih. And it's mentioned in Bukhari and Muslim as well. Who knows what is the hadith? The most well-known one. Well-known and authentic. Because sometimes you have well-known, famous, but not authentic, not sahih, could be da'if, I don't care. رواه اتفق عليه الشيخان. Do you know what is it? طيب. It's called حديث الامرأة السوداء التي كانت تصرع. Literally, a black woman came, this is by hadith, came to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. She said, يا رسول الله, إني أسرع. She used the word سرع. The literal translation for the word, linguistically speaking, of سرع is epilepsy, which is a disease that we know it. Okay? She said, يا رسول الله, I have سرع. سرع, from medical point of view, is called what? Epilepsy. Which something has to do, problems with the brain and the electricity and something. قالت يا رسول الله, but at that time, it was not defined as a medical disease at that time. Be careful that. Try to understand the history, the context, the time, the language. But the word that she used in Arabic is سرع. She said, إني أسرع. طب, what is the linguistic meaning of السرع? When someone is thrown into the ground, it means سرع. If that's why we call wrestling in Arabic is what? مصارعة. مصارعة الحرة. Free wrestling, we call it in Arabic مصارعة. Why مصارعة? Because literally in Arabic, if someone is thrown into the ground, it's called سرع. صارعه فتصارع. As long as this act of sports, MMA, taekwondo, whatever, what do we call it now? We used to call it the Roman wrestling. مصارعة الرومانية. Free wrestling. مصارعة الحرة. Most of these, at any moment, the point is that one of them is trying to throw the other into the ground. So in Arabic language, throwing someone into the ground is called صرع. Okay? She told Prophet Muhammad, يا رسول الله إني أسرع, which means I have a problem. This problem causes me to be thrown into the ground. This is the meaning of أسرع. Okay? Linguistically I'm talking. Now, طيب, you know, I mean, medically we have, شوف سموه بالإنجليزي, let me set it, التشنج. Cramp, spasm or stiffness. Okay? Sometimes when we have the stiffness in our muscles or have the cramp or something, you know, this is part of the problem of the epilepsy type. Now she said, إني أسرع. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن شئت دعوت الله لك. She asked the Prophet, let me read the hadith, wait, I forget part of the hadith. She came to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Sorry. Sorry. Yes. قال ألا أري اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. أتت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قالت إني أسرع وإني أتكشف فادعوا الله لي. She said, يا رسول الله, I'm facing the صرع, which means I have some kind of status. I'm thrown into the ground when I face this, you know, problem. فَادْعُوا اللَّهَ وَإِنِّي أَتَكَشَّفُ فَادْعُوا اللَّهَ لِي أَلَّا أَتَكَشَّفُ. When I face this, you know, because of the cramp and stiffness or something, she might be taking part of her clothes from her body. So part of her body might be exposed. So she came to Prophet Muhammad to ask him the following. Ya Rasulallah, قال وإني أتكشف فادعوا الله لي. Please make dua, you know, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to me to help me in this problem. Now, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إن شئت صبرت ولك الجنة وإن شئت دعوت الله لك أي عافيك. He said, if you wish, be patient for this trial, this disease, this challenge, and the price for your patience on this disease, this marad, this difficulty, this tahaddi is what? Al-Jannah. وَإِن شِئْتِ دَعَوْتُ اللَّهَ أَيُّ عَافِيَكِ. And if you wish, I will ask Allah just to heal you and everything is finished. But your patience will lead you. It's like in our times now. Someone is facing cancer. Ya Rasulullah, if Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is speaking with him, Ya Rasulullah, ud'allah, this will lead to the Jannah if you are patient. What she decided? لاحظ يعافيك, to protect you from this problem. فقالت أصبر. فقالت no, I want to be patient, because if I know this will lead me to the Jannah, I have no problem. خلاص, this is part of my test. As long as you are telling me that this test will lead me to the Jannah, I'm satisfied. جزاك الله خير يا رسول الله. Then she continued, قالت إني أتكشف فادعوا الله لي ألا أتكشف فلا دعا لها. She said, يا رسول الله, just a small part of the problem. Make dua for me not to expose any part of my body when I'm having this status of صرع. فدعا الله لها, الله حافظها. The bulk of the problem stayed with her. There is no mention for the jinn. There is no definition that the صرع, according by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's a medical problem. It's a disease. It's whatever, call it whatever problem. Okay, no mention. At least if she's controlled by the jinn, he will ask her, read the mu'awwadhat, say something. How come he will leave here and she's controlled by the jinn? Where is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? No, this is part, it's like someone has headache, migraine. How many of us have migraine? Maybe 50% of us. Huh? Problem. And you know, ما يصيب المؤمن من هم ولا غم ولا نصب ولا وصب حتى الشوكة يشاكها إلا كفر الله بها عن خطاياه. Any kind of difficulties, challenges, problems, you know, concerns, diseases you face, you accept them, that part of the trial by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will uplift you and will give you more the ajr, which is part of our. So there is no mention. طب, why did this idea came to some people? To the best of my readings, before Islam, Arabs, pagans, generally speaking, the tradition, paganistic idea, it was spread among the Arabs, Arabic Peninsula, that when someone is facing what we know as epilepsy, they used to think that he is controlled by the shaitan. This is an Arabic jahili what? Idea. But as long as we are discussing ghaib, ilm ghaib, we can't say this is the no, because of the shaitan. Where is the dalil? Actually, all the adilla say something else. Are you with me? All the Quranic adilla. Why I will remind you again with the very powerful Quranic verses about the shaitan. Not depend on my memory. Very quickly, just the words of the shaitan. How? Look. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. فوسوس لهم الشيطان يعيدكم الفقر استزلهم الشيطان, you know, whispering cause them to sleep, يخوف أولياءه, spread the fear, وما يعيدهم الشيطان إلا غرورا, promises them, وزين لهم الشيطان ما كانوا يعملوا. He make it appealing, okay, decorated thing, decorated, زين, وسوس, استزل, nothing, all you go. You know, إِمَّا يُنْسِيَنَّكَ الشَّيْطَانُ, if he caused you to forget. What is the clear-cut evidence that helps the idea that I was highlighting? Do you know what is it? By the way, I recited this clear-cut evidence at least two times last time. At least two times. Do you know what is it? Who can remember it? مين عم بحكي من السماء؟ لا, the clear cut that the shaitan has no direct physical power against us. نعم, الله يجزيك الخير. نعم. وقال الشيطان لما قضي الأمر إن الله وعدكم وعد الحق ووعدتكم فأخلفتكم وما كان لي عليكم من سلطان إلا أن دعوتكم فاستجبتم لي فلا تلوموني ولوموا أنفسكم ما أنا بمصرخكم وما أنتم بمصرخي إني كفرت بما أشركتموه. One of the most powerful evidences that the shaitan did not have the power that is claimed that he has now, as some people think, that he controls the body and he gets into all of this, with the way that we understand it. He has the power. I will explain to you why, but another type of power. When you submit yourself, this is something else. But he has no power just when he decides, he gets into your body and to the position, which is the talabbus, and he starts speaking, your tongue will be speaking in another language. Sheikh, شفتوا تلبسوا الشيطان وسمعت الشيطان. Are you really? Yes, he was speaking Sanskrit, Sheikh. I said, do you understand Sanskrit language? I said, no. How did you know that he was speaking Sanskrit? حسبي الله على الهبل. والله قال شيخ, he was speaking Chinese. والله, do you understand Chinese? No. How did you know that he was speaking Chinese? With me? Now, what does the Quran say? The Satan will be delivering a speech for human beings in the day of judgment before everything finishes. وقال الشيطان لما قضي الأمر. Everything settled down. خلاص. Accountability, the حساب, the people of the Jannah, the people of the Nar. Now, خلاص. The final phase, everything is closed. Files are closed. تطايرة الصحف, everything. قال الشيطان قضى إن الله. He's now giving the last speech. قال إن الله وعدكم وعد الحق. Allah has promised you the truth. ووعدتكم فأخلفتكم. And I promised you and I broke my promise. Now, افتح قوس, highlight. وما كان لي عليكم من سلطان. I did not have any kind of authority upon you, any kind of power upon you. إلا أن دعوتكم. Except that I called you. Whispering, reminding, fearing. This is the evidence. فاستجبتم لي, and you accepted my invitation. فلا, don't blame me. Blame yourself. It's your problem. Now, in light of this, طيب, the final thing in the last 7 minutes. Can the shaitan control me? Yes, طبعا, he can. But not through the position. My idea, I want just to tell you there is no evidence on talabbus. No evidences. Which people think that the full control. But can the shaitan control? Yes. In other ways, with other approaches. What is the dalil? Inna ibadi laysa laka alayhim sultan illa man ittaba'aka min al-ghawin. Which means if someone decided he himself to submit himself for you, you can't control him because he decided to submit himself. The other evidence, وَأَنَّهُ كَانَ رِجَالٌ مِّنَ الْإِنْسِ يَعُوذُونَ بِرِجَالٍ مِّنَ الْجِنِّ فَزَادُوهُمْ رَهَقًا. Men from the human beings, they used to seek refuge by the shayateen, so they controlled them. I've submitted myself. I accepted. Are you with me? So this type of control, yes, it's possible. When I accept you, when I have fear from you, when I want to deal with you, let's not go far. Just don't go so far. If someone decided to deal with the mafia and he liked their ways and he wanted to be a criminal like them at a certain point, now he knew their power. Their, you know, scary ways, how they assassinate, they kill, they do, they reach, whatever. At a certain point, he had some slight thinking that he might think to leave them. Just one telephone call. One telephone call. Not from the boss. The fourth secretary of the boss. Hey, if you ever think, just think, it's not just you will be lost. Your family will be burned alive while you are watching them in the street within 24 hours. So know your place, shut your mouth, come now. He will come. طب is there a direct physical power to controls him? ما في. But he's completely scared, submissive. This is control. Mafia can control you. Any security force, especially in the Arab world, can control you. If you decided to have fear from them. That's why dictatorship regimes, they can't deal with believers except by assassinating them. Wallahi, because they can spread fear against non-believers, because non-believers are ready to believe in anything. They worship their desires, they worship whatever, money. So they come to them through money, through drugs, whatever. So they can't be afraid. But you don't feel afraid except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who can scare you? No one. That's why they... Inshallah, you will go to the Jannah. Inshallah. Wallahi, I'm not joking. I'm giving you a real example. A real example about... إن عبادي ليس لك عليهم سلطان إلا من اتبع look very clear إلا من اتبعك not إلا من سيطرت عليه just you have a control just on those who decided to follow you. طيب أنا تقريبا خلصت سامحني بس لأنه she raised up one question here one question that I will finish. تفضلي. She's asking why we still see a lot of people, they go to shuyukh to read for them. Is it the first time in the history of Muslims that khurafat is spread among them? Is it the first time? It's one of the horrible misunderstandings among Muslims. We are not living in our best times. طيب سؤال. Logically, mathematically. The shaitan, when he decides to harm someone by doing opposition, talabbus, it's because he wants to harm you because you might be a good believer. He wants you simply to destroy your life. Who is more enemy for the shaitan, the sahaba or hadratna? Whom do you think is much more having big status of enmity against the shaitan and against the abalis, the sahaba or us? Sahaba. طب how many cases it was reported to us that sahaba they faced talabbus? All of them? Not even one case?
Zero.
يعني الشياطين ما كانوش يشتغلوا وقتها؟ كله ماخذ إجازة؟ بيشتغلوش غير عندنا. Oh, by the way, I'm just giving, and I know, and the problem that politically, I can't highlight everything because some countries, they paid money to spread this idea. Money. The country that you know. Money. Wallahi. Because, you know, by the way, believing in such things is a type of drugs. ليش ما نجحت في التوجيهي؟ عملوا له عمل. ليش مش عارفة تدرس؟ راكبها جني. ليش تتهاوش مع زوجها؟ مش لأنها بتطلع على MBC3 وبتطلع على كل الانستغرام وبتحكي مع لا 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 راكبها جني. ليش الولد ليش بضرب مرته وهو ساته عريس جديد؟ مش لأنه وقح، مش لأنه أمه ما ربته، لا 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 راكبه جني. The best shama'a, the best solution to escape from all kind of responsibilities. That's why it's completely backwardness, تخلف. We will not hold any kind of responsibility. وشو صار جني؟ تلبسني جني طرقوني عين، حسدوني ضرجوني. The end result, I will do nothing in my life. Do I have full justification? Yes. رسب التوجيهي طرقوني عين. معيتها؟ ما سلمت الشغل وما خلصته عملوا لي عمل. زعلت كل الناس اللي حوالي وسرقت دول عم ليش؟ سحروني. يا سلام. This is the best تخلف recipe for the أمة مسلمة. والله. طبعا معلش he's before you then احنا I think we have just 2 minutes quickly تفضل.
شيخ مثال
أحد إلا من تبعك منهم كشيطان. تبعك is it like when they follow سحر and go?
No. Generally, you accept the steps of the شيطان. قال ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان. Anything leads to حرام is خطوات الشيطان. Anything leads to hate Allah, to be far from Allah, this is خطوات الشيطان. And I know it, so I decided to accept it in this way. So the end result, I'm following the steps of the shaitan, because this is طريق الرحمن طريق الشيطان is very clear that this is an compared with this one. It's not يعني can anyone claim that drugs, for example, drugs or porno is not طريق الشيطان? For example, is there a person with the power of intellect with minimum does not know that drugs and porno is not طريق الرحمن? Yes. So if I'm insist to go through this, not just I was weak and I did it once. No, I'm dealing with it. I'm working with it. I'm spreading it. إن الذين يحبون أن تشيع الفاحشة وفي الذين آمنوا لهم عذاب أليم في الدنيا والآخرة والله يعلم. Allah is telling us that a group of people يحبون أن تشيع الفاحشة. What is this? يحبون. They feel happy when this kind of shameful things are spread among the people. For you have people, they decided to follow the shaitan. Final question very quickly. Wait, not to harm? طيب, let's say the concept of عين, the evil eye, and is it true that we might be harming the jinn or not? Next time I will explain them, inshallah. تمام? Remind me if I stayed alive, if the jinn did not do anything for me, okay? عشر ونص, yes. Sorry, والله, I missed. شرحناها بأربع حلقات. طيب. It's your first time.
والمرأة اللي كان عندها نزيف وبعدين ذهبت للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال إن هو من الشيطان.
ما بعرف الحديث لكن I will search it, I will try to explain it next time إن شاء الله. It's a huge topic. بس إحنا السحر أختي شرحناه بأربع حلقات الماضية. ريت إذا تسمعيه وإذا تحبي قبل ما تيجي الحلقة القادمة. مشان ما أعيده. الله يجزيكم الخير. السلام عليكم.